The 2019 NBA free agency predictions. Now, this is a free agency that is actually one of the most insane free agencies of all time, in my opinion. Yeah, we've had some pretty good free agencies, and I'm talking about star level talent. Melo, LeBron, Wade, Bosch. The 2010 free agency was pretty good. But this free agency is even better, or arguably better, simply because of the depth of this NBA free agency. Of course, we still have the star players like Kevin Durant, Kawhi Leonard, Kyrie Irving, Klay Thompson, who are great players. They're not as good as LeBron, Wade, Bosch, Melo in that 2010 free agency, but the depth in this year's NBA free agency is arguably better. And also, can we just note how many players start with K? Kevin Durant, Kawhi Leonard, Kyrie Irving, Klay Thompson, Kemba Walker, Chris Middleton, Kristaps Porzingis. Like, this is the free agency of the Ks. Anyway, without further ado, I just want to say a massive, massive thank you recently for all the support. You guys have been insane. All the likes, all the new subscribers, welcome. I appreciate it so much. Anyway, let's get into it. Number one, Kevin Durant. Kevin Durant is obviously the biggest name in this year's NBA free agency because we kind of don't know where he's going to play. Kawhi is up there as one of the biggest names, but we sort of know he's going to either choose one of two teams. Kevin Durant could choose one of three, in my opinion. Obviously, he can rejoin with the Golden State Warriors, a 5-year max deal, or he joins the Brooklyn Nets or the New York Knicks. Do I see him joining any other team? Not really. I think he joins one of the three. But I don't want to just be that guy who chooses a whole bunch of teams, and obviously he's going to go to one of those teams. I will try and name the team that I think he'll go to, but obviously it's so hard. He could join the Golden State Warriors, but the reason why I don't think he joins the Golden State Warriors is because I don't think that his legacy will allow him to join the Golden State Warriors for 5 more years, and people look at him the same way than if he joined a new team and won a championship with his new team. Kevin Durant, if he did re-sign with the Golden State Warriors, number one, would not play next season with the Warriors. Number two, he's gonna want a 5-year contract. And considering that the next 5 years are pivotal in shaping the legacy of Kevin Durant, I don't think he will want to spend the next 5 years in Golden State. Not because he doesn't find them a great team, and not because he doesn't love his teammates, but I think when you look at Kevin Durant and the psychological aspect of it, I just don't think he's gonna want to be known as a guy that was a snake throughout his career, joined the best team of all time, won championships there, and that's about it. Like, to me, he could be a top 5 to top 10 all time, but I just don't know if he can be if he has that legacy of just staying with the Golden State Warriors. So, I'm going to cancel the Golden State Warriors out. I don't believe he re-signs there. So I believe if he did go back to the Golden State Warriors, it would be for a 2-year contract. Honestly, he won't play next year, but he would play the year after, and then he would probably go to another team. So that's what I think, but I believe he joins a new team. And my prediction, if you guys knew me from a very long time ago, you know that I made a video about why Kevin Durant will sign with the New York Knicks. Now, a lot has changed. He did tear his Achilles, and the Golden State Warriors lost the NBA championship. So, that is some big factors into why Kevin Durant may not join the New York Knicks. The other factor is I thought Kyrie Irving would want to join the New York Knicks, but now I have the feeling that he'll probably want to sign with the Brooklyn Nets. I believe if Kyrie joins the Brooklyn Nets, Kevin Durant may join him. I believe that Kevin Durant will join the Brooklyn Nets. I mean, just imagine if he like swerved us all and ended up joining the Boston Celtics. That would be insane. Number two, Kawhi Leonard. He had the potential to join the Clippers, and only now with the Lakers freeing up a max spot, he now has a meeting with the Los Angeles Lakers too. Now, the two LA meetings do suggest to me that he really does want to come back to LA, but ultimately, leaving the Raptors after winning a championship, I just can't see that happening. The thing is, this year might be an indication of what happens in the future, such as next year or the year after, and Kawhi Leonard could be on the move next season to an LA team. The Lakers would be so interesting though, and they probably have the best pitch out of any team. You can tell Kawhi Leonard, hey, we've got Anthony Davis for the future. Forget about LeBron James. When LeBron James retires, it's gonna still be you and Anthony Davis. As for now though, you have LeBron James, Kawhi Leonard, and Anthony Davis on the same team. That would be insane. The only thing is, who else are the Lakers going to be able to fill up their roster if they give all their money to Kawhi Leonard? And is Kawhi Leonard really that type of guy that would join a big three like Davis and LeBron? I just don't think he is. I believe he's going to go back to the Toronto Raptors on a 1-year deal, revamp, see how well they can go next season, and then depending on how well they go. The next year after that, I could see him joining the Los Angeles Clippers. Number three, Kyrie Irving. Considering we kind of touched on this before with the Kevin Durant move, I'm going to say that Kyrie Irving joins the Brooklyn Nets, and Kevin Durant may join him, but if he doesn't, I think Kevin Durant goes to the Knicks and Kyrie Irving joins the Nets. My prediction is that Kyrie Irving joins the Brooklyn Nets. Number four, Klay Thompson. Okay, I think the Warriors 100% offer him a max contract, so my prediction is that he stays with the Golden State Warriors. If the Warriors, for some reason, do not offer him a max contract, he will join the Los Angeles Clippers. Number five, Kemba Walker. My prediction is that he joins the Boston Celtics. I still believe that the Boston Celtics are a free agency destination. Now, they're going to lose Kyrie, in my opinion, and they're going to lose Al Horford. That does not mean they can't find a replacement for those two. I believe Kemba Walker could be a decent replacement for Kyrie Irving, and I believe they could get a center that can definitely replace Al Horford. So, if I'm the Boston Celtics, I believe I can still get a good name free agent, and I think that Kemba Walker will be that guy. Number six, D'Angelo Russell. Will he join the Los Angeles Lakers like many people are saying he will? I do not believe he will, and I think the Indiana Pacers are in a prime position to land a guy like D'Angelo Russell. They can make a push for him. They can make some noise in the Eastern Conference with the duo of Oladipo and D'Angelo Russell, and I wouldn't be surprised if the Phoenix Suns also made a push. And in my opinion, I'm going to go with an outlandish call, and I'm going to say if he signs under the max contract, he will join the Lakers, but if he signs for the max contract, he'll either join the Phoenix Suns or the Philadelphia 76ers. So ultimately, I know that you guys want a one-team prediction, and I'm just going to go out there and say it will be the Philadelphia 76ers because they will lose Tobias Harris and they will lose Jimmy Butler. And he is great friends with Ben Simmons. It's just a prediction video, guys. Calm down. Number seven, Jimmy Butler. My prediction is that if Kevin Durant joins the New York Knicks, the Brooklyn Nets will target Jimmy Butler to pair up with Kyrie Irving, and that would be my prediction for Jimmy Butler. But because I do think that Kyrie and Kevin Durant will join forces in Brooklyn, I'm going to say that Jimmy Butler will end up in a Los Angeles Lakers uniform, and they will have Jimmy Butler, LeBron James and Anthony Davis as the big three, and I also believe he will take a slightly less than a max contract with the Lakers, which will allow them to get some other free agents that aren't minimum contracts. So that would be my final prediction for Jimmy Butler, but I also wouldn't be surprised if he returned to the Philadelphia 76ers and then there was a sign and trade deal in place. The only way I see the New York Knicks getting him is if they don't get a guy like Kevin Durant or Klay Thompson or Kyrie Irving or Tobias Harris. If they miss out on all those guys, then yeah, I could see Jimmy Butler going to New York, but I think that the New York Knicks will land somebody instead of Jimmy Butler, which means that Butler won't end up in New York, if that makes sense. See, that's what I mean where I say that one player can dictate the whole of this year's free agency. Chris Middleton, I believe there is no way he does not re-sign with the Bucks, so that's my prediction there. Tobias Harris. I believe Tobias Harris will end up in New York. Once the top guys make their decision, it will be so much easier to know where these players will go. But once again, it's a free agency prediction video. You have to go a little bit outlandish, and I do believe that Tobias Harris will end up in a New York Knicks jersey, but it really will depend on where other players end up. This is where I think it will get a little bit more interesting as well. We're going to go into the centers of this year's NBA free agency, and there's a lot of them. Number 10, Nikola Vucevic. I think Vuce is a lot of NBA teams' fallback option. I believe he is the New York Knicks' fallback option, the Lakers' fallback option, the Boston Celtics' fallback option. In my opinion, I think he should go to the Boston Celtics, and then the Boston Celtics actually keep Terry Rozier. That would mean that at this point, the Celtics still have Terry Rozier, Jason Tatum, Jaylen Brown, Marcus Morris, and then a guy like Nikola Vucevic, and I do not think that's a bad team, but because I think that the Celtics will go after Kemba Walker, I don't really know where Vucevic will go. I think there's a few options, but ultimately, like I said, I feel like he'll be a backup option, so I'm just going to say a few teams for him. One is the Knicks, one is the Lakers, one is the Celtics, but I actually think he could have a chance to end up in Sacramento, considering that Willie Cauley-Stein is out. But in saying that, I would have no surprises if he went back to the Orlando Magic. After looking at the teams that he could go to, I honestly believe at this point, the best thing for him is just to stay in Orlando. So actually, I change it, and I believe that that is my final prediction, the Orlando Magic. Number 11, DeAndre Jordan. I believe that he actually has the potential to join the Los Angeles Lakers. I believe personally that he's a guy that won't ask for a lot of money, And I believe that he's either going to the Lakers or the Nets. But unless the New York Knicks sign Kevin Durant, I believe there is no way DeAndre Jordan goes back to the Knicks. The reason I say the Lakers is because they need a center. And he's a guy that they can go after and is not going to ask for a lot of money. But it really all depends on whoever else they can get on the roster. And this is if they don't get another free agent like Jimmy Butler. In saying that, if they can get Jimmy and DeAndre, it is a wrap. And ultimately, it wouldn't surprise me because Jimmy Butler and DeAndre Jordan are great friends. And if Jimmy Butler takes a contract under Max and DeAndre Jordan says, hey, do you want to play together? They could both end up in a Lakers uniform next to LeBron James, Anthony Davis, and Kyle Kuzma. It's a wrap in my opinion. But personally, that will take a lot of sacrifice for not only Jimmy Butler, but of course DeAndre Jordan, but we've seen stranger things happen in the NBA. I mean, DeMarcus Cousins for $5 million last season with the Warriors. You never know what can happen. And I do have a slight feeling that he could go over to the Brooklyn Nets and pair up with Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving if my prediction goes to plan. So my prediction is, if he doesn't join the Los Angeles Lakers, he will join Kevin Durant. And if you want to know why I think that, you can click the link below or on the screen right now. That will take you to my Why Kevin Durant Will Join the New York Knicks video, which explains why DeAndre Jordan and Kevin Durant are the best of friends. Number 12, Al Horford. I believe this team will go after Al Horford 100% and they will land him, and that is the Dallas Mavericks. Dallas would be a great fit for Al Horford considering they have Kristaps Porzingis, they have Luka Doncic. They're going to be really exciting next season. And that's my next player on this list, Kristaps Porzingis. I believe he has to sign back with the Dallas Mavericks and there is nowhere else he would go. So the Dallas Mavericks could end up big winners in this year's NBA free agency. Number 14, DeMarcus Cousins. Now I would not be surprised if the New York Knicks make a push for DeMarcus Cousins and actually land him. I believe they're going to land one of these two, Julius Randle or DeMarcus Cousins. I think the New York Knicks will end up with either Julius Randle, DeMarcus Cousins, to pair up with a player like Tobias Harris. If they don't get Kevin Durant, I think the New York Knicks will definitely get Tobias Harris or Jimmy Butler, and one of the two, DeMarcus Cousins or Julius Randle. DeMarcus Cousins is not the same player that we once knew and we once saw as the most dominant big man in the league, but he did show signs last season and he will have a full offseason to get healthy again. And I still think he could make some noise next season and be a 20-10 guy. And I think if you compare that up with a guy like Tobias Harris, the Knicks will be actually decent next season. But this is the dilemma that I'm facing if I'm the New York Knicks general manager. Number one, why would you get DeMarcus Cousins if you already have a young and upcoming player in Mitchell Robinson at the center position? You can get a point guard, and then you've still got RJ Barrett, and let's say they sign a small forward like Tobias Harris, then why would you get DeMarcus Cousins if you have Mitchell Robinson? Unless you play DeMarcus at the four, but I just don't see that happening. So if I'm the New York Knicks and I'm going for fit, I would go after a free agency point guard, then I'd have RJ Barrett, Tobias Harris, Julius Randle, and Mitchell Robinson, and that would make more sense if I'm the New York Knicks. But at the end of the day, Mitchell Robinson may be a guy that they leave off the bench, and since DeMarcus Cousins is coming off an Achilles injury, maybe he won't ask for max money, and he'll ask for quite a bit less than max money, and he can be on a team with Julius Randle and Tobias Harris, and that would mean big things for the Knicks. This is a prediction video. But it is so hard to predict where these players will go, so I'm going to say that both Julius Randle and DeMarcus Cousins will go to the Knicks, but I believe that one of them will and one of them won't, and if I'm going to pick a player that will, I would say it would be Julius Randle, and for DeMarcus Cousins, I literally have no idea, but I'm going to go out on a limb and say the San Antonio Spurs. That is my bold prediction. And the last player on this list is Marc Gasol, but he's already opted in to join the Toronto Raptors, which gives me another feeling that Kawhi Leonard may be on the Raptors as well. And just to say it, I'm going to go with some other guys that you probably didn't think would be on this list. Carmelo Anthony, the Los Angeles Lakers. Terry Rozier, the Phoenix Suns. J.R. Smith, the Los Angeles Lakers. Marcus Morris, wouldn't be surprised if he joined the New York Knicks or the LA Lakers either. And the last player on this list, Derrick Rose. I still wouldn't be surprised if he ended his career in the Chicago Bulls. Being a backup point guard, let them trade Chris Dunn away, keep Derrick Rose, and see what happens from there. With that said, if you guys enjoyed this video, let me know by hitting that like button and hit that subscribe button if you're new. These were my predictions. I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know your predictions down below. Subscribe if you're new, and I will catch you guys in my next video. Follow me on Instagram to keep up to date with what I get up to, and I'll catch you guys in my next one. I am out. Peace.